Okay, give her a round of applause. Woo!
Thank you. I'm Ida Dame, not Roy van de Heuvel. I work with Roy van de Heuvel at the University of Eindhoven, the Technical University. And we're interested in healthy office environments. So what we plan to do is see if we can integrate movement within working behavior. So how can we make sure that people aren't sitting all the time doing their work? And what we plan to do is create technological solutions, human-centric and context-dependent, and see if we can really make movement part of an office environment and create a more healthy environment. That's it.
Oh, thank you. Oh, my name.
Wait. Do you plan to start?
Yes. My name is Ineke Hazendep. Sometimes you need medication for your medical care. There are so many drugs available, and your doctor will prescribe the medication that will fit to your medical condition. It's now possible to prescribe this to you online or digitally. For digital health, there are so many apps and devices available. And why isn't it possible to prescribe these to you digitally? Let's create a personal online assistant to choose the right tools which will fit to your medical condition and to you. We will make it possible to prescribe digital health digitally. And I'm looking for developers, data specialists with experience in HLZ or FHIR, designer and healthcare professionals like doctors or nurses.
So, woo! Thank you, Lisa! The fog. Here you go. That's okay.
Alright, I'm Paul Jutten. I have diabetes, type 1, for 18 years. And I want to improve the predictability of the blood sugar level. I want to know for many years, and I collect my related data for so 3 years. Very much data, and I want to know if there are any patterns find with the data. I think very interesting. So I think I have to do with something with that. So I look for data scientists and data analysts and that kind of people. I'm the developer too, so I know a lot of techniques.
So if you want to join. Let's go.
Ik ben geen jongen, ik ben een namme, Emmanuel omgekeerd. Ik wil niet groot worden, samen, ik doe het niet alleen. Ik loop alleen aan de arm, spannend. Ik heb geen kun, ik ben een kan. Ik heb geen wil, geen kies, geen keus. Ik heb geen hoofd en nog ook geen denk. Deze woorden kwetsen mij en doen mij pijn in mijn hartje. Ik heb geen contact met familie, ik ben dakloos. Ik vertel niets, ik luister naar je. Ik ga het niet doen, niet alleen, nooit, want dan gaat het fout. Bam, ik wens ook een mooie kamer met mooie spullen. Ik hou van donderdukjes, kleuren en plakken. Ik wens een vriendin dat er altijd voor mij is, waar ik niet op grapjes mee kan doen. Ik wens liefde en maatje aan de hele dag. Ben jij er nog? Ik zeg tot ziens. Doedels! Zojuist hebben jullie gehoord hoe Emmanuel over zichzelf praat. Emmanuel heeft geen contact met zijn familie en zijn netwerk is beperkt door zijn begeleiders. Het is zijn liefste wens om een vriendje te hebben met wie je af en toe kan praten en af en toe lichamelijk contact kan hebben. Helpen jullie mij om het voor Emmanuel mogelijk te maken om op een veilige manier te oefenen met contact maken? Hiervoor heb ik nodig een ontwerper, een programmeur, een ontwikkelaar, iedereen die een Emmanuel wil helpen.
Wauw!
Yeah, obviously I'm not Danny. My name is David Kolman. I'm a medical student, and last year I had to sleep in a hospital. I experienced cold, I experienced light that interrupted my sleep, and we thought about that's not good because good sleep helps patients' conditions to improve. We want to design a capsule a microcosmos for the patient where the patient can regulate light, smell and stuff like this on his own and can sleep better during his stay at the hospital. To realize this technically really complex project, we're looking for developers, we're looking for designers, we're looking for creatives to help us improve this and make it possible. Thank you.
You can introduce yourself.
I will. If you didn't understand design, then you have experienced our problem. Think about how it makes you feel. Oran and Michael can talk. They use sign language. The professionals often don't understand Oran and Michael. Both sides get frustrated. Oran and Michael keep making the same signs over and over to hope that the professionals will understand them. The professionals can always give the care they need and ask for. It would be handy to have something on my smartphone that could read signs and translate it to me so I can understand them and learn signs at the same time. Please help me solve this problem of my clients. Oh, I forgot, my name is Monique Owners. And I'm a professional of the mental health and mental disability. I work with people with mental disability. Can we develop a technology that reads sign language and translates it for the professionals so they can understand the thoughts and wishes from the client? Eventually, this technology can be used everywhere in the Netherlands. What do I need? Designers, developers, programmers, people who know sign language, data scientists, and problem solvers.
Thank you! Thank you on the job, please! Project number 63, Indy Smits. The floor is yours. Oh, sorry.
Hello, I'm Indy, and this is Peace. Ladies and gentlemen, how is it possible that at the end of this year, Dr. Canavero and his team will perform world's first head transplantation? But we can't even properly measure inpatients' posture and activity. In fact, in medical centers these days, data collection is done by manual counting. Electronic devices available on the market now are not suitable for everyday use in the hospital. What we have is an open source sensor with validated data, and what we wish for is a smart algorithm, maybe with some artificial intelligence, that is personalized, can communicate with a personal health record, monitors and activates in patients. So we don't need a brain surgeon, we do need developers, designers and people who love data.
You probably remember the last time you had an emotional outbreak. Some people with an intellectual disability experience this on a daily basis, resulting in poor behavior like screaming, hitting, grabbing, hurting others and themselves. We call it problem behavior. I would like to prevent this behavior and its consequences. In our project, we focus on measuring physiological variables like heart rate and skin condition with a wearable worn by a couple of clients. We already did that. Now, we would like to explore the next step. My name is Mara Nagelke. I'm a behavior therapist at CISA, and I need help in further exploring, predicting, preventing from disability. I'm looking for engineers, data scientists, behavior scientists, designers, care professionals, and experts by experience.
Thank you, Mara.
Hello, everybody. I'm Caroline Blijlevens, and I learned from experience that information from family and patients and who suffer from mental illnesses, this information is not used. This information from family about what's going on in the mind of their relatives is not used properly by the professionals. I would like to make a solution and a tool where family and patients themselves are facilitated to give the input about their well-being, about what's going on, about how they feel during the day. So not only this 1 hour that they are in have a consult with their caregiver, but also on other days, times, whenever they need it. So I'm looking for a developer, a data specialist, a designer who can make a great tool to help me out. Thanks. Woohoo!
Ladies and gentlemen, we do forget. Whether it's medical or non-medical cases, we do forget. We forget names, we forget things to do, we forget memories. What if our devices can remind us of these memories, the things we need to do? We are using computer vision to associate things with our memory. We are developing this algorithm, we have a data scientist, we have a design, we need a developer to bring this brilliant idea. Join us. Thank you.
Thank you. Who doesn't want to remember?
I'm Gijs van den Brink. I had 3 years ago a stroke. I can not walk anymore, and my dream is to walk to my daughter and play with her. As at this moment, not you have people with dwarslesie, they have an exoskeleton, but there is not something for people that one like me, where right or left and ik ben linkshalf, rechtshalf of verlamd. Hoe kan me helpen? Er is en er kan zo, zo much in now, but I don't know exactly what is the possibility. So I hope. And it is not only for me, it is also for people with the same problem. They have to sit in their
wheelchair.
Thank you very much.
Thank you, guys.
Firstly, I will do something on purpose. I will drop something on purpose, even though there's pressure of time. This is silence. It's a meaningful silence. After this, what also happens after a doctor tells a patient that someone is severely ill. And in this silence, the patient thinks, he must have the wrong file, and I don't even feel sick. The patient's partner thinks, how long will she live? And what will I wear at the funeral? The doctor thinks, this is the third one today I had to give real bad news. How much longer can I cope doing this? How can we help these people in reflecting on their spiritual lives and the meaning of life after having heard some bad news, or even at the end of the life? Under pressure of all the new developments in the healthcare system, these issues seem to go on the background, and I would like to develop a tool to communicate wherever the patient is and whatever the patient needs to talk about. Thank you! Yolanda. Only Yolanda. Oh, you changed everything.
I'm sorry, I pitch in Dutch. My English is not good.
It's okay.
Goedenavond, fijne mensen. Ik ben Jolanda Maaij, ik ben 56 en ik heb artrose. In 2015 heb ik een nieuwe rug gekregen. Vermoeidheid weg, pijn weg, voor mij een halleluja. Eindcontrole bij de chirurg, een half jaar later, u mag ook de andere kant. Nou, denk ik niet. Want een prothese gaat maar 10 tot 15 jaar mee en ik wil honderd worden. Na 3 jaar verder met zelfmanagement en zonder klachten. Ik ben mijn eigen experiment geworden met de hoofdvraag: hoe lang lukt het mezelf om geen artrose klachten te hebben door aanpassing van onder andere mijn leefstijl? Ik daag jullie dan ook uit om dit experiment van zelfmanagement ook beschikbaar te krijgen voor de groeiende groep van 1,1 miljoen mensen met artrose in Nederland. Dank u wel.
This is depressing. Good evening, everyone. I'm going to share with you just a brief story about myself and where I come from. About 4 years ago, I lost my aunt to depression. This is something that we did not see. She had lived with us for over 7 years of my life and nourished my uncle. And she had her first child. So within the first 1 year, we just saw her mood change from being the happiest woman that she'd find in her room to be more quiet, reserved. I want to be alone. So for us, we had no knowledge of what was going on. We assumed it's just one of those. Within the same year, she committed suicide. When everyone was going to work, we came back that evening and said, overdose herself. There's nothing to happen. And just last year, I also had the same experience. My first startup crashed. We had a lot of money. So imagine you succeeding for the first time and you lose it overnight. I couldn't bear what was happening. So for 6 months, I decided to leave everything. I couldn't touch a laptop or talk to anyone, not even my family, because I thought I'd be less of a man if I started talking about emotional stuff. So what we want to do now is use artificial intelligence to help the patient understand when they're going through something and give them the feedback that they need to do what. Thank you.
Thank you. The last project. Another? I saw you. Just in time.
Yeah,
I'm
thinking
about
stress.
Save the
legs. Hi, I'm Bowser. Our project is we need to develop an app or an application, to prevent a burnout. And we have a tool, a measurement tool. We gather data. Kunchai is doing it as we speak because we want to monitor her stress level. And it's not difficult to monitor and to gather data. But to change behavior, that's very tricky. And 50% of the long-term illness and the disability to work is due to burnout. So we really need to do something. And we have to change behavior. And we want to co-develop an application that, based on data, is going to change behavior. And what we need, we have data. We gathered data last week in 5 locations of Hacking Health. And we need UX design or product thinkers to work with us on changing it.
Thank you. The last one. Wow, give them all a big applause!